I'm from Q93 Radio and CFCY, and I'm the MC for the third year in a row here for the Dancing with the Stars for Hospice PEI. It's going to be a fantastic show. There is a lot of stars lined up. We have some extra special dances lined up, and I think the audience tonight is in for another real treat. It just gets better and better every year. I've seen some of the rehearsals and some of the costumes, and it's looking really good, so it's going to be a really good show. Makes me feel alive. I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the
things that we could be. This is one of our major fundraisers for Hospice PEI. We are an independent, not-for-profit organization that does depend on the funds raised through events like Dancing with the Stars. We helped 270 island families with over 5,500 volunteer hours in 2013, and we'd like to continue doing that for islands.
So what do you guys think of this tonight?
It's going to be great.
It's going to be a fun time.
Are you glad you're not dancing?
Yes.
This was very good to my family, and I thought this would be an excellent fundraiser to help them out with. So I told them I couldn't dance, but they said they'd teach me. And
well, you did a really great job, and we're both really proud of it's a really hard routine that you're doing. We're impressed.
Thanks, and you know what? Susan and Rajan have been great teachers, and I think we'll do excellent. Yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey.
Just taught him two steps, and I chose whichever one he did best.
I didn't know either. When she said cha-cha, I didn't know either. But anyway, I went with what she suggested, and I learned it. And
the pinnacle was whenever you learn to put the steps with the music. Whenever you could pick out the music with the steps, and that was pretty cool. It was about mid-August.
Yeah, okay. It was great. I'm really enjoyed it.
I'd really like to thank Monique. Monique has been a great coach. She's been so patient and just helped me out so much. I really appreciate it, Monique. Thank you very much.
Well, I appreciate you coming on board last minute like you did, and it's been wonderful. It's been a great experience. And it's too bad it's going to be over tonight.
Yeah, exactly. We'll have to do this on some kind of a monthly basis.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. Megan, what do you think of your dad doing this to raise, you know, awareness and everything for hospice?
I think it's a great fundraiser for sure.
And what do you want to say to him tonight?
Good luck. Don't mess up.
Okay.
Thank you.
It's been a hoot. It's been a blast. We've laughed. I mean, I learned a lot. Now I actually would feel comfortable slightly on a dance floor. It was way more fun than I would have ever thought. Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, more than welcome. And it's been a lot of fun for me as well. It's been a real challenge, and it's really nice to have made another good friend.
John and his wife Susan are just fabulous, and I'm so honored to get to know both of them, and I hope I'll continue to know them on a going forward basis because they're fantastic people. Thank you for everything.
You're welcome. Kim, I cannot ask. I didn't expect that she can learn an open routine so fast and so well. You were wonderful.
Thank you.
Do you think you guys are going to get one of these?
Oh, of course.
Do it for your daughter, right?
For my daughter.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Lick your hair. I've been losing sleep, dreaming.
Jamie Cudmore.
I'm Susan Lessard.
And we're here tonight dancing for hospice with Dancing with the Stars.
And why did you decide you wanted to do this thing?
Hospice was very good to my family, and I thought this would be an excellent fundraiser to help them out with. So I told them I couldn't dance, but they said they'd teach me, and Susan did.
And what's it been like?
It's been excellent, actually. A lot of hard work, a lot of practice, but a lot of fun, too.
What is the hardest part of it for you?
I think the memorizing the steps, being so many of them. So that's sort of been the challenge for me.
How many steps?
A lot.
Now, what about for you to try and teach someone who's not a professional? What's it been like for you?
Well, it's been actually great. Like at the first lesson, he was better than we expected. And yeah, it's been pretty easy.
Yeah, and yeah. For you, why are you here tonight?
Well, they invited me, and it sounded like fun and exercise, so
and
that's why I'm here.
What will you be doing tonight?
Tango.
Tango? Yeah. Why that? Is that your choice or his choice?
We had to choose from what dances were available that everyone else hadn't picked, so I guess it was my choice.
Hello, it's Mark Rod here from Rod Hotels and Resorts, and my pro or teacher is Julie McIsaac.
Hi, I'm Julie McIsaac from JC Styling Salon.
And why did you decide you wanted to do this tonight?
Because it's a great fundraiser. I love hospice.
Now, did you pick Mark or did he pick you?
I actually picked Mark.
And what was he like?
Yep.
Whoa. I didn't know that.
And what was he like the first time compared to tonight? What words would you use to describe?
Not bad.
Ooh,
much improved now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and for you, Mark, why did you say, I want to do this?
Well, I want to do this because in 2006, my father passed away, but the last 8 weeks that he was with us, he spent in hospice palliative care. And the organization, the association was amazing. They did such great work. They're great for my family and for my father. And when they called me to be involved in this, there was no second guessing. I had to do it. Even though I can't dance, but even though that's not the case, but I had to do it, and I wanted to be involved.
Now, for people who haven't had, you know, the benefit of hospice, what did it mean for you folks, for your family?
Well, I just can't. The last 8 weeks of my father's life couldn't have gone any smoother or better for him or for my family, and I know it's a hard thing that families have to go through, and unfortunately we did. But thank God for that organization, the association, because it just made it that much easier for our family to get through, and for my father. And so it was great. And so that's why I'm here tonight.
And what would David think of you, his son, doing this tonight?
Well, he'd be laughing because he was a dancer, and I'm not a dancer. He was a good dancer, and I'm not that good of a dancer. But I'm here tonight, not yes for my dad, but I'm here for the volunteers of hospice because they were phenomenal. And that's what I'm dancing for here tonight and trying to raise money for. So that's my cause tonight.
Okay, and what dance did you folks choose?
We chose the cha-cha. And I also had about 6 clients of mine go through hospice, and so it's a worthy cause.
It touched you personally.
Very much so. Very much so. And I have clients who are on the board, and I think I was in the first year. So.
And what would you like to say to each other before we?
Oh well, I want to thank her because I'm not the easiest student, and she did a phenomenal job. She's a professional, and she's very busy, and she gave her time to work with me, and I'm not the easiest person to work with. So, anyway, that's just great. You know, it was great.
And what do you want to say to Mark?
Mark, you've come a long way, and I'm very proud of you.
Oh, well, that's nice. That's nice.
Well, good luck tonight.
Great. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Hi, my name's Monique Kay, and I'm involved with the Hospice Dancing with the Stars tonight. It's a really worthy cause. They're a great group of women, and they do lots of good work for the community.
Hi, and I'm Robert Mitchell, and I'm extremely pleased to be here tonight to help out in a great fundraiser for Hospice PEI, who perform a very valuable service for island families in their biggest time of need. So very pleased to be here and be a part of this tonight.
How long did you have to think of before you said, okay, I'll do it?
Oh,
over the phone.
It was pretty quick. I got the call. I said, I'll call you back in a half hour. And I called back and said, look, I'd really love to be part of this. So it didn't take me too long. And once I knew Monique was going to be my partner,
of course.
It was real easy.
And he probably learned half his routine the first night he showed up. So really good.
She's being too kind.
Really good.
Good student, eh?
Yeah, very good student.
So which dance will you folks do tonight?
We're doing the jive.
And who picked that?
I think I did.
At him and said,
I think I did.
Yeah, Monique picked it, but it's probably my favorite dance. So I'm very, very glad for that.
Why, have you danced the jive a lot?
I've tried to jive before in a kind of a butchered fashion. So now I know some actual real moves. Absolutely.
So he'll dance his heart out tonight after the competition.
Yeah. Yeah. And for you, Robert, what was the hardest part about learning to do this and knowing that it's going to be in front of everybody?
Well, the hardest part, I guess, is just to kind of keep your routine, the steps in order and keep it in your head. But I think we're there. We feel we're there tonight, so I think it's going to go hopefully flawlessly tonight. So
it will. My dancing is so...
What were you saying?
I said I needed all the help I could get because my dancing is so...
We'll see tonight.
I have the best coach, though, in the entire world.
Carol Williamson, and I decided to come tonight because it's an awesome event, number one. I love to watch people dance because I'm not that great at it. And I love what hospice does.
I'm here because my wife asked me to, and I thought it would be a great occasion to make a deposit into an emotional bank account.
Hi, I'm Alana Yenkov, and I'm here tonight to dance the samba. Why am I here?
Hospice.
I'm definitely here for hospice. I'm also here to challenge myself. I'm not a dancer, so it's been a huge work in progress, so here we are.
My name's Scott Kay, and I'm supposedly a pro. We'll use that word loosely. But Alana's done a great job, and the main reason I'm here is to support the hospice organization. They do great work, and she's been a lot of fun working with. So looking forward to a fun evening this evening.
Alana, what's been the toughest part for you about learning to do this and knowing that you're going to be doing it in front of a big crowd?
I don't have any beat. I have no rhythm in me. So it was I had to learn muscle memory right from the beginning. So that was the biggest thing. And I find it more challenging doing it last night at rehearsal in front of 20 of our dancing peers than it maybe will be tonight. I don't know. I just want to get through it.
And for you, what's it been like with having someone who's really not a dancer who you have to take through this whole journey?
I think that's pretty much what happens at all of these events. But I was in it 2 years ago in the same situation, only a little different in that both the girls had dance backgrounds. So that was nice. This time around, it was a challenge, but it was a lot of fun. Lana's been great. We've had a lot of laughs doing it, I can tell you that. And I think we put together a decent routine. I think people will like it.
Yeah, what are your chances of winning tonight, you think?
Well, I don't know. I was hoping.
One out of five.
I was hoping it was going to be like at the exhibition, you know, where everyone wins a prize, you know, and you go to the duck pond, well, win a prize. Yeah.
She's definitely going to get a prize for the best looking girl here.
I think it's you know, not to sound sappy, but to complete this routine is enough of a prize for me.
It's a goal.
Oh, absolutely. And it's for such an amazing cause.
And what brings you here tonight?
Oh, I'm supposed to be dancing with the winners.
But you let Robert Mitchell go up.
Well, no, I won't be. No, I'm with Robert's partner. That's who I'm dancing with.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, my name is Kim McInnes, and I'm here to sponsor a great organization for a great fundraiser.
My name is Regent Lessard. I like dancing a lot, and what a good way to help to fund for the fundraising. I cannot find a better way.
And which one of you is the pro?
I'm not sure.
You are. And so why did you say, I want to do this, I want to get in front of everybody and dance?
I was asked in front of my three-year-old daughter, who went around telling everyone that her mama was going to be in a dance competition, and I couldn't break her heart, so I had to do it.
And which dance will you be doing?
International Foxtrot.
And why that one?
Because we were the last one to be team up, so we have not a lot of choice.
That sounds like it's one of the harder ones.
It's really hard. Our routine is an open routine. It's not simple.
And how has she improved from the time, the first time you saw her dance?
Oh my, tremendously. At the end, she trained three times a week. It's fantastic. I cannot ask more to Kim. I'm really proud of her.
Thank you.
So you put in a lot of hours.
Yeah, yes I did.
Like how many?
We started out one day a week practicing for an hour, and now we're up to 3 days a week for about an hour and a half each time.
Wow. So your daughter's really going to be proud. Is she here tonight?
No, she's not here tonight, but she's been at every single dance practice singing Let It Go for us, so we've practiced that song, although we're not dancing to it.
Okay, well, this video will be available, so you can look in here and so you can watch it. Why don't you say hi to her?
Hi, Chloe!
This is my family. And, great supporters.
Hi, I'm Julia Sauve, and this is my third year with Dancing with the Stars PEI as a judge. And then tonight, we're also privileged to have my Dance for the Health of It ladies who dance doing a piece called Something New, which we did in the Dance Umbrella Show last year. We also have another group here from the Holland College School of Performing Arts, which is awesome.
And what do you think when you have someone, a professional, trying to help someone else who's not a professional to learn to dance? What do you think of this whole concept?
I think this whole concept is fantastic. I think it's life-changing. I think it's wonderful.
Life-changing?
I do. I think it's life-changing.
Why do you say that?
Because I would say for the most part they're learning a skill that maybe they haven't really done before. Like maybe they like to go out dancing, but then when you're learning ballroom and you're working with a partner and you're learning how to count and how to do a particular style, it's huge. And then maybe you would say, oh, I want to do more of this type of thing. So you might take more, you might bring your spouse, or you might do more ballroom dancing. And in that way, I think it's life-changing.
Okay, well thank you very much.
You're quite welcome, Pat. Have fun.
Disappointment was my closest friend.
Hi, it's Gerard Murphy, and I'm here tonight for the Dancing with the Stars, and I'm on the other side of the table tonight. The first 2 years of the event, I was dancing, and then this year they asked me to come back to judge, so I get to put the pressure on their dancers. It's a very important cause for me. I remember a couple of years ago when the hospice asked me to be a part of this. I said I would, because a hospice means a lot to me, because my wife passed away 6 years ago because of cancer, and the hospice really helped out our family during that that terrible time. So I'm glad to be back and helping out.
And what was the experience dancing? What are your memories of that?
It was hard work. It's really hard work. We spent a lot of time. We started in June, and of course the event is in October. We went once a week, and then we did it twice a week. So it was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be.
And now, when you're judging, have you done any homework about how to be a judge?
No. You know what? I'm gonna be pretty easy on everybody. I'll be pretty generic with my comments, and I'll look for subtle mistakes, but I don't think I'll point them out. But I'll be fair.
Any advice you want to give to the new people who are just doing this tonight, the new dancers?
Any advice? The only advice is have fun, enjoy it, just live in the spotlight tonight, and just enjoy the whole evening, because it's going to be a blast.
How's it going now, Robert?
It's going good, Pat.
You're not nervous yet?
Look at this.
He's doing pretty good.
Yeah, hanging in there.
Thank you. So how's everybody doing in here?
Great.
Not nervous or anything?
Not at all.
You're all ready to have fun?
We're ready.
Okay.
Ready to go.
I'm nervous.
How about you?
I'm really nervous.
Your wife?
I'm really nervous.
Okay, maybe you better go outside for fresh air.
That's what I have in the back.
Okay. Good luck, guys. Have a good night.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Charlottetown Legion. Hospice PEI's Dancing with the Stars 3. How's everyone doing tonight? You are a fine-looking crowd tonight, I must say. Okay, many thanks to our wonderful pros who have been working really hard. Now, this just didn't come together this past week. They have been dancing since May, end of May, 1st of June, and they put a lot of hours in. So many thanks to our pros and our stars that have taken part. First of all, the pros, Scott and Monique Kay, Rajan and Susan Lazaire from the Ballroom Barn, and Julie McIsaac. And many thanks to our Jive sponsors, Maritime Electric and Fair Isle Ford. And many thank yous to some of the other folks that helped put this evening together. Amanda Squires of JC Styling for helping with hair and makeup this evening. Davis Ward for providing the DJ services. Margot Posma's here for the music direction as well tonight. The Legion for providing this wonderful space. Annette McKinnon of Sugar and Spice Bridal Boutique for the beautiful decorations. Didn't they do a lovely job on the tables? Wonderful. And also Hearts and Flowers for the sunflowers and all the tables this evening. Now, one more thing, just before we get rolling here tonight and introduce you to all of our dancers, I'd like to introduce you to someone very special who's the Executive Director of Hospice PEI to tell you a little bit about the organization. This is Alana Sprague.
Thank you, Paul. As Paul mentioned, my name is Alana Sprague, and I'm the new Executive Director for Hospice PEI. I wanted to take a moment to thank you all for coming this evening to share in this wonderful event. I've never attended this before, so I'm really excited to see how everything goes, and I hope that you are as well. Hospice PEI has been assisting Islanders for almost 30 years and provides volunteers to people who are dealing with a life-limiting illness and to family members who have experienced a loss. In 2013, we assisted 270 island families with over 5,500 volunteer hours. Thank you. This support can happen in a number of ways. It can happen in hospital, in long-term care facilities, at the provincial palliative care unit, and at home for those clients that wish to spend their final days with their families. We are able to provide these services free of charge because of the wonderful support of, from people like you. We often say that people give what they can when they can, and Islanders are amongst some of the most generous people around. So a hand for yourselves. I would like to thank again our presenting sponsor, National Bank, the stars and pros who are about to entertain us here this evening. I wanted to say a special thank you to Jamie Cudmore. I'm not sure who saw the front page of the paper today, but there was a really wonderful article. Thank you so much. We're so glad that he was able to share that, and he was just really open, and we're thrilled. I would like to thank our amazing volunteers, our judges, our wonderful MC, Paul Allen, the Legion staff, and everyone else who was instrumental in pulling this event together. And of course, I can't do what I do without my amazing staff who gives 110% every day. Have a wonderful time and enjoy the evening.
Thank you, Alana. Okay, any sight on the glasses yet? Did they turn up anywhere? Are we still looking for them? Okay. Well, we would like to say hi to Pat Martell, who's videotaping the event again for us tonight. We're very happy to have him here. And just before we meet our dancers, we have some distinguished judges that you should be introduced to right now, because they're going to be offering some comments after each of the dances and giving us some insight as to what they thought of the dances. So first and foremost, let's get to them. The judges' table is right over here. I wish I had a spotlight to show, but it's right over here, right next to Pat. Okay, so you can see here, I've got on the far, my far left is Julia Sove from the Holland College School of Performing Arts. Little wave, Julia. And Julia, this second or third year you've judged with us? Third year, okay, welcome back. Also joining us is, now this is quite a resume she gave me here, more than anybody else. Don't give me this we're in line, I just asked for one line, what do you do? And I got this resume. Okay, so she was in The Drowsy Chaperone. Boy Meets Girl, that's at the King's Playhouse tomorrow night?
Next weekend,
okay. And also the artistic director for Feast Dinner Theater and heavily involved in musical theater on the island, it's Sherry Lee Dara, everyone. Also rejoining us this year, judge last year and a contestant in the first year who ended up winning the People's Choice Award, it's Stephanie Rainey. Wave, Stephanie. There you go. Last but not least, the token male on the panel tonight. Been a friend of mine for many, many years in the broadcast industry. Even though we play in different sandboxes, we're still good friends. It's Gerard Murphy from Ocean 100. Now, are you ready to meet some dancers? Okay, what we're going to have is a little introduction dance before they're all going to come out, and I'll be introducing them to you, and then they'll go backstage, and they'll shake off their nerves, and they'll come out and do their individual dances, okay? Sound good? All right, here we go. Music, please. Oh, that's the theme, too. Nice. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Alana Yankoff and her dance partner, Scott Kay. Would you please welcome Jamie Cutmore and Susan Lazard. Now entering the dance ballroom, Robert Mitchell and Monique Kay. Would you welcome Kim McGinnis and Rajan Lazard. They are happy. And our final contestant tonight, Mark Rod and his dance partner, Julie McIsaac. Ladies and gentlemen, our stars and our pros, Dancing with the Stars 3, give them a big round of applause. They need the encouragement. All right, guys, thanks so much. You go backstage and get ready. So there's the nurse, getting the nerve shaking. Robert, you okay? Oh, he's good, he's good. Excellent. Mark says he needs help. Yeah, no kidding. Okay, I'd like to introduce you to our first contestant tonight. And our first contestant is an established island artist whose work has been exhibited at the Confederation Center of the Arts, among other galleries. She's an accomplished entrepreneur with 20 years of experience successfully managing her own company called Image Factory for many years. Proven marketing and communication skills, an active volunteer in the community, Holland College Distinguished Alumni Award recipient, and recently supported the PEI government in its events and planning protocols and strategies, and one crazy chicken, I'll tell you that. She's currently the executive director of the Guild, ladies and gentlemen. It is Alana Yankoff and her dance partner. Would you please welcome Scott Kay and Alana? They're going to be dancing the samba, and it's to the tune I've Had the Time of My Life, and I'm telling you, no one puts Alana in the corner.
Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth.
Scott Kay and the samba. Now, we're going to go and meet with the judges and see what they have to say. What do you say we kick it off with Gerard tonight?
Well, thanks very much, Paul. Certainly an honor to be here tonight. It was a great dance. I loved it. I love that dance. And like Paul mentioned, you've been working at this since the 1st of June, and it certainly showed. The footwork was fantastic. I love the hair. The hair is great. And you looked like you were having fun, which is the important thing. And you did a great job. Excellent.
Yeah, right from that first dip, you were confident and poised and graceful. It was really beautiful. You looked like you were having fun. And you look beautiful tonight, Alana. You're very lucky to have Scott as a partner. He was my partner 2 years ago. We did the cha-cha too. He's awesome. You did a beautiful job.
Thank you very much, judges. And Murph, I'm really surprised to hear to see how much you like the hair. Okay. Jealousy. Thank you, Alana. Thank you, Scott. Let's hear it for him one more time, ladies and gentlemen. And don't forget to vote. Don't forget to vote. Fill out those forms on your table. Let's get some money for hospice, and they'll be getting some tallies for me and passing it along to you a little bit later on the program. Okay, our second contestant out tonight is the manager of the Scotiabank's Sherwood branch, Jamie Cudmore. He lives in Stratford with two of his three children. Jamie's very active and involved in the community. He served on various charity boards and participated in numerous fundraisers over his 11 years at the Sherwood branch. In 2011, Jamie was named the National Volunteer of the Year for Scotiabank and also Junior Achievement Volunteer of the Year. And in his spare time, Jamie enjoys spending time with his family in various sporting events, including hockey, golf, and running and cycling. I was asking Jamie about this performance tonight and how he got along, and he said not so bad. He said it was kind of tough trying to learn to tango to music that he wasn't really familiar with. And then lo and behold, about 2 weeks ago, his dance partner, Suzanne, says, okay, or Susan says, let's change it up a little bit. Have you ever heard the song by George Thorogood called Bad to the Bone? He went, I get it now. So here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Jamie Cudmore and Susan Lessard doing the tango Bad to the Bone.
Woman beg, and I make a good woman steal. I make an old woman blush, and I make a young girl squeal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad. Bad.
All right, all right. Jamie Cudmore, Susan Lessard, and the belt says it all. Let's go to our judges now and get their response. First, we'll hear from Sherry Lee Dara.
Sorry, okay. Wow. From the get-go, right from that first pose, you were like, I got this, here I am. Very good, I loved that. You came out and you're like, yeah, here it is, check this out, it was awesome. I love this really intense music with this graceful swirling. It was really cool. There is this, every now and then you kept getting this little like look in your eye where you kind of like smile and you're like, yeah, I don't know. Personality for me says it all. And that right to the very end where you did the last pose and you were like full eyebrows up, you're like, check this out, everybody. It was great. You both looked wonderful. It was great. Congratulations.
Thank you. Julia?
Really good partnering, Jamie. Wow. And wonderful choreo, Susan. I really like the way you used this, the whole space. Even did, you know, into the corners and nice and full and very challenging dance, the tango. So thank you so much. I thought you did a wonderful job working together. Really great.
Thank you so much, judges, and thank you, Jamie and Susan. Awesome job. Vote, vote, vote. Good work, guys. I was having a chat with a couple of friends of mine earlier, Carol and Steve in the back, and Carol asked me, why don't I dance? I've been here for 3 years. Why am I not dancing? Well, truth be known, I came out in June and auditioned, and I wanted to show off my awesomeness on the dance floor. And I auditioned for the pros, and they all had the same reaction. It was, you're ridiculous, so I'm not allowed to. So hence I'm on the microphone again, and happy to be here. Our next contestant tonight is Robert Mitchell, first elected to the Ledge back in 2007, a Liberal member of the Legislative Assembly. He was elected to represent the urban riding of Charlottetown, Sherwood. And Robert has had a successful career both as a longtime employee with Maritime Electric and as a partner in a local stone business, and has also worked in the real estate industry. He's a dedicated community volunteer, and he's been active in his church, and has volunteered with various teams in both Sherwood Parkdale Minor Baseball and the Hockey Association. Robert and his wife have four children, Ryan, Jordan, Megan, and Brandon. And I was asking, I'd like to ask the dancers, what's the story behind their dance? And well, see, with Robert, he gets in trouble when he's in the Ledge, when the house is sitting, because the premier looks over and Robert's like, he's not praying, he's texting. Should be praying sometimes, I think. And he gets in trouble for texting. And so that's the basis of our dance tonight. Monique does not like him texting at all. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Mitchell and his dance partner Monique Kay dancing the jive in the mood. Bush Dumble and Buck Watts are here. Guys, have you ever seen anything like that before? Is it going to be the entertainment at the Liberal Christmas party this year? Yeah? Poor Speaker of the House, Carolyn, can't catch a breath over there from laughing so much. Okay, let's meet the judges now. Gerard, what do you have to say about that dance?
Wow, well, that was great. Now, most politicians talk a lot of jive. But you danced a lot of jive tonight. You did a great job. I think I've never seen you move so much in all my life. The timing was perfect with the music and the moves that you did, and you did a great job, both of you. Fantastic.
Robert, you showed how when a woman finally manages to get her man's attention, what he can do. Really great partner for Monique. He even had lifts and catches, and it was awesome. I can tell. I know. You were really concentrated, but I could tell you were having fun. And you really got that jive step down pat. That was awesome. Way to go.
Thank you very much, judges. Thank you, Robert. Thank you, Monique. And just before we get to our next dance, I'd like to remind you to vote. We're going to have some volunteers come around right now and pick up any of your pledges or any of your votes that you would like to place on some of these dancers tonight. And we'll see how well and how much we can raise for hospice tonight at your tables. And while we're getting the volunteers to come around and collect, did anybody find the glasses yet? Wait a second. Hey, you, are those burgundy glasses? She's not even listening to me. Burgundy glasses is what we're looking for tonight. Still nothing. Karen, we're going to have to take up a collection for you, I think. Okay, I'd like to call on Alicia McGuire, who's a hospice volunteer, is going to come up and say a few words for us. I think Alicia is at the rowdy table in the back. Here she comes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Alicia McGuire, hospice volunteer.
Thanks, Paul. In October of 2002, my husband, Brian McGuire, was diagnosed with prostate cancer. He was 58 years old and he had no symptoms. He had carpal tunnel in his hand, and all he wanted to do was to get that fixed up so he would be ready for the next golf season. The routine blood test taken at his initial doctor's appointment to get his hand fixed showed a high PSA count. Because the subsequent examination found nothing else, it was thought he might have a urinary tract infection, so he was referred to a urologist. Yet his PA, antibiotics and further testing followed. He felt great, he still had no symptoms, but his PSA level continued to climb. The doctors did some biopsies, and we thought, worst case scenario, he might have to have surgery to have his prostate removed. Unfortunately, this was not the case. Instead, Brian and I, our four children, and our eight grandchildren were stunned to learn that Brian had stage 4 prostate cancer, and that surgery was not even an option because it had already spread to the bone. We were dumbfounded. This was a man who went for yearly checkups, took no medications for anything, and was a happy, vibrant, and well-loved member of the community. Brian was a man of great faith, and he battled hard for 5 years following his diagnosis. At times, he became very fatigued and undoubtedly endured more pain than we would ever let on. He never was one to complain or feel sorry for himself. I remember a minister coming to visit him at the house and saying, "You must be angry, Brian." To which he replied, "No, I am not angry." The minister prodded, "Well, at the very least, you must wonder why me." I will never forget his response as he looked at the minister and simply and sincerely replied, "No, Reverend, why not me?" Eventually, he had to give up the job he loved so much as manager of the Merle Co-op store. We lived right across the road from the store, and I can still see him standing in our front porch with his hands clasped behind his back, calling, "Lish, come out and see all the cars over at the store." My family and I did what we could to keep Brian as comfortable as possible at home, until we realized he needed much more help as his pain increased. A bed became available in the palliative care unit. Brian was very apprehensive about going there. He said, "This is the end. If I have to go there, I will never get back home." But he went anyway because he really had no other choice. He was toxic and needed to get his medication adjusted. Right from the start, as he got on the unit, he was treated with such respect and dignity. The nursing staff and volunteers were so awesome with him. Everyone from kitchen staff to cleaning staff talked to him. He loved them all. It was here that we had the good fortune to meet Dr. Mireille LaCourse. She was a godsend to our family, and Brian loved and trusted her. Once his meds got adjusted, he was able to come home on some passes. Home care and hospice workers cared for his needs at our home, and they all treated him with such respect and compassion. When Brian was leaving palliative care in July of 2007, he looked at Dr. LaCourse and asked if he could stay home this time. He knew his time was getting short, and he wanted to die at home with dignity and grace, surrounded by his family and close friends who loved him so dearly. On August 17th, 3 weeks after we celebrated our 43rd wedding anniversary, with a mass and meal at our home, Brian's earthly journey ended. With Brian's death, a different journey started for me and our family. The grieving process was and is very difficult. 2 years ago, I took the hospice volunteer training course. And ever since, I have spent my Thursday afternoons at the palliative care unit, trying to give a little something back for all that was given to us during Brian's illness. There's another way our family and the community tries to give back too. When Brian was a teenager in school, he was given the nickname Onion. In 2008, a committee consisting of members of Brian's family, friends, and community members was formed. This year, we held the 6th annual Brian McGuire Memorial Golf Tournament, fondly known as the Onion, and which I am very proud to say has raised $156,500 over the past 6 years. Monies which have been split equally between the palliative care unit and hospice PEI. What a legacy. Brian would be so humbled and so very honored. Last year, at the tournament, Dr. LaCours announced that the common room at the new freestanding hospice facility, currently under construction, will be named in Brian's memory. It will be a room where people will gather to talk, laugh, cry, and just be together. I'm sure if Brian has anything to do with it, there will be some nice Irish music playing in the background. I thank you all for your kind attention. I ask a special blessing for all of you gathered here tonight as you all go on your own unique journeys. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you very much, Alicia.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was very kind of you. That's why events like this is so important to raise money for Hospice PEI, as it is not funded through the government. It relies on private funding and fundraisers like this to continue on with this wonderful work. Okay, don't forget, the volunteers were going around picking up pledges. They're still doing that right now as we get ready for our next dance. Oh, and by the way, I would like to say hello to a couple of alumni dancers here tonight. Oh, he's hiding his head. MP Sean Casey is here. And his lovely wife, MLA Kathleen Casey, is here. They are both from season one. I was over putting the fear of God into Sean, saying, you know, there is that open spot at the end of the night where anyone can get up and dance in front of everyone else. And he says, never again. But I understand if we should get a tray of shots over to that table, maybe. We might see him out on the dance floor again. Thanks for coming out, guys, and supporting Hospice PEI. All right, our next dancer tonight is an investment advisor with National Bank Financial, our title sponsor tonight, as well as an avid horse and dog lover. When she's not busy with work, Kim can be found on the training field working with her dog in the sport of, I've never heard it before, Schutzhund? I didn't swear, that's Schutzhund. Okay. She's also a very enthusiastic photographer. She collects burgundy framed glasses, and she lives in Darlington with her younger daughter and has an assortment of animals. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome to the dance floor as we get rolling again, Kim McGinnis and Rajon Lazard doing the foxtrot to All That Jazz.
Thank you. town. And I'll let jazz and rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And I'll bet jazz stop the car. I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold, but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl. And all of that jazz. Slick your hair and wear your buckle shoes. Is gonna blow on the blues. And all that jazz, hold on, hon. We're gonna bunny hug. I bought some aspirin down at United Drug. In case we shake apart and need a brand new start to do that.
And Rayshon Lazard. As we go back to the judges' table again, Sherry Lee Dara is up first. Sherry Lee?
I love this pink dress. It looks really great. You guys are great. It was so much fun. I was like, ooh, when you're spinning around, I was like, oh gosh, their feet, keep them apart. So awesome, so good. I loved your back, all those like beautiful back dips with your head. It's so beautiful. Your lines were so nice. Am I saying that right, Julia? Her lines were nice. Yeah, your lines were really nice. Congratulations, guys. I loved it.
Julia.
Thank you so much. I really enjoyed just watching the sense of fun that you had with that whole entire number. I love the way you worked with the music. Like, that's what really jumped out to me, was all of the accents of the music were there, and beautiful things that you did with your arms, and some challenging things that you did with the footwork. Yay, good for you. That's really great job.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Kim McGinnis, Rayshon Lazard. Good work, guys. If you filled out the form on your table and wanted to vote, just hold up your hand and one of our volunteers, they're like spies out in the audience, they can see you, they will see your hand up, so then they'll come running over to your table to collect your money and your ballot as well. So just hold your hand up. Okay, our final contestant tonight, but there's a lot of great dancing after the contestants while the judges are tallying their marks. Our last contestant, third generation in the hotel business, it's Mark Rod. Mark began his career in the hotel industry as a bellman of all things at the Rod Charlottetown. While attending high school, Mark earned a degree in business at UPI in 92. And upon the completion of his degree, he re-entered the family business in various management roles. In 97, Mark and his sister Christina branched out and began Rod Development Limited and actively grew the Burger King franchise in the greater Halifax area. Mark is the sole proprietor of Dooley's franchise in Yarmouth, Nova Scotia, and also has a number of investment properties throughout Atlantic Canada. And he's my new best friend. I'll give you my card later, okay? In 2010, Mark sold his shares to Burger King to his sister, but he held on to the giant king head that he likes to wear around the house once in a while. It's quite a treat. He's now the president and CEO of Rod Hotels and Resorts, and Mark's goal is to continue to build on the success of his father and grandfather and welcome his guests in with true maritime hospitality. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Mark Rod and his dance partner, Julie McIsaac, dancing the cha-cha rumba to sing. He's gonna disappear. I gotta tell you a little story first, that just before we get rolling here. First of all, this one here, she showed him a little dance move in the back and almost took my nose off, giving me the slap. You're supposed to pull the slaps. Okay, here's the story. They're a couple, they're out for dinner. they get into an argument, yes? Oh, keep going? And now they're in for a fight, right?
Oh, yeah.
A big fight. Are you going to punch him like you punched me?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, my ribs are still hurting. Oh, see, she's a fireball. Ladies and gentlemen, Julie and Mark.
It's late in the evening, lost on the side. I've been sad with you for most of the night. Ignoring everybody here, we wish they would disappear. So maybe we could get down now.
Good to see you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Rod and his dance partner, Julie McIsaac. Let's go to the judges and see what Gerard Murphy has to say.
We're working out? Good. The cha-cha I know, because I've done the cha-cha a couple of times, and you did a great job. Very expressive, very animated. I loved it. The important thing about the cha-cha is the hip movement. You got to make sure you're moving the hips. Mark, you did a great job. And he did a great job on the chase as well. Very smooth, and it looked excellent. Great job.
Stephanie.
So, Mark, people usually make reservations to stay at your hotels, right? But
I don't think anybody here has any reservations, but that was awesome. You did so well. What were you thinking messing with the beautiful, talented Julie? What were you thinking? But you learned your lesson. You got that cha-cha rumba down and you acted fantastic. It was just so much fun to watch. Congratulations.
Let's hear it again for Mark Rod and Julie McIsaac. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we saw all of our contestants tonight. The judges have really got a lot of work cut out for them. Good work, buddy. Don't go too far away now. The judges have their work cut out for them. They're going to start to tally up their results, and we've got some more dances coming up here tonight. And before we continue on with any more dancing, I'd like to introduce you to Carl Arsenault from the NART National Bank, our presenting sponsor tonight. We'd like to come and say a few words tonight. Carl?
Start off by thanking Hospice PEI for allowing us the opportunity to be a presenting sponsor for this event. A great event. We appreciate all the work they do. I know you do as well. I won't bore you. No one wants to hear from a banker. A lot of times they call and they're collecting money or something. So that ain't the case tonight. Unless you want to give money to Hospice PEI, they can certainly use it. A little bit about National Bank. We have two branches in PEI, one here in Charlottetown right on Kent Street. We're a full-service bank. We have commercial, our National Bank financial partner, which Kim McGinnis is a investment advisor who is a wonderful person. She'll be happy to take your money and make it work for you. No slight to my Scotiabank friends over there. I had to get a dig in. Ah, you know, I had to. They're a good bank too. And I'm the branch manager in the Summerside branch, which is right next door to Scotiabank, so we're buddies there too. Anyway, thank you very much. Again, we thank you having the opportunity to be a presenter here, and we hope you have a wonderful evening like we're having a wonderful evening. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Carl.
Of the world, just rolling along, just rolling along. And I am quitting the blues of the world, just singing a song, just singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, I just phoned the parson. Hey, Pa, get ready to call. Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm gonna fall. I am sitting on top of the world, just rolling along, just rolling along. Ah, go get 'em, Billy. Glory, hallelujah, I just phoned the parson. Hey, Ma, get ready to call. Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm about to fall. I'm sitting on the top of this world, just rolling along, just rolling along. I'm sitting on top of the world, singing a song.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Rayshawn and Susan from the Ballroom Barn. Thank you very much, guys. Good work. We're still collecting votes. You can just hold your hand up. Volunteers are here collecting them right now. Any great place else in the ballroom, the volunteers are collecting. Many thanks for your votes and your money for hospice tonight. Now we are going to have a good experience. We've got the Holland College School of Performing Arts here tonight to perform Wild Country. Please welcome them to the dance floor. Thank you.
School Performing Arts Wild Country. Nice work, ladies. Remember I told you about my audition? They stole it. That was mine. Plagiarism. The only difference being I wore white pants. It didn't look quite as good when I was through. They did a great job. We've got another set of dance that come out right now. It's called The Ladies Who Dance with something called Something New. Ladies, The Ladies Who Dance.
Gentlemen,
gentlemen, gentlemen, gentlemen. You never seen the likes of me, baby. Where I walk in the room, where I walk in the room. Nothing you better make a scene, darling. So let me tell you the news, tell you the news. Hey, have you heard? There's a new sensation. Extra, extra, I'm coming at you. I know you want it, baby. You know it's true. The beat is popping, it's moving you. It's always happening.
Ladies Who Dance. What a great job. Were they ever having a ball out there? Thank you so much. Let's hear it for them again. Nice work, girls. That was awesome. We have another dance for you tonight. This one is called Clumsy Lovers. It's a musical medley.
Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen, down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. Tis you, must go and I must buy. But come ye by when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. I love you so.
$100. And Windsor White. Good job, good job. Awesome work. Okay, I'll tell you what, I'm not sure if we have the totals yet from the judges. If you want to grab a quick drink at the bar, if you want to raise your hand and get some more votes, and good job, Windsor. Good job, man. And get some more cash in for Hospice PEI. We'll take a real short break, and then we'll be back with the trophy presentations this evening.
Just about ready to go back to Mr. Tripod. He's getting some more waves. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I'm really happy to announce that Karen found her glasses. Apparently, where was the table? Just in the back there, that trouble table I told you about? A lady found it earlier and she had it on Amazon Kijiji trying to sell them. Didn't get it, so she ended up turning them back in. We're very happy to. Yeah.
again. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood. And whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell.
So what I'm going to do is announce some of the winners, and Alana Sprague, our executive director from Hospice PEI, will be awarding the trophies to our recipients tonight. First, you know what we should do? We should have all the dancers come out first. All the dancers and their partners, please come return to the dance floor. All dancers and their partners are returning to the dance floor once again. We have Alana and Scott, Jamie Cudmore and Susan Lassard, Robert Mitchell and Monique Kay, and Kim McGinnis and Rajon Lazard, and Mark Rod and Julie McIsaac. Wonderful, wonderful job. Okay, now we're going to have to make room somehow for you to go over and get the trophies, Elena. Oh, Ellen's going to pass them to you and you're going to present them. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, for style and poise, our recipient is Alana Yankov. Style and poise. Way to go. And our judges chose this next couple as the dynamic duo. And that's going to Robert Mitchell and Monique Kay. Best performance of the night. The drama. That's going to Mark Rod and Julie McIsaac. Okay, we're down to two final spots here. And the People's Choice Award, this was based on your votes and the money we collected tonight for hospice. And many thanks to all of you. The winning vote was 7,090 votes. 7,090 votes for this one dancer. Congratulations to the recipient of the People's Choice Award, Kim McGinnis and Rajon Lazard. And ladies and gentlemen, the judge's choice tonight. Our winners of the Judge's Choice Award, Jamie Cudmore and Susan Lazard. They get the big trophy. Fantastic job.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for all of our dancers again. This is a big thing, coming out, putting yourself out there and dancing in front of a crowd. If you want to see that trophy up close, head out to Scotiabank in Sherwood. He'll have it proudly displayed. Congratulations to all of our dancers once again. And the party is just starting, everyone. We're going to have the music rolling with Davis Ward throughout the evening. So if you want to get up and show us what you've got on the dance floor, you're more than welcome to. Thank you one and all for coming out supporting Hospice PEI. It was a fantastic night. Let's hear it one more time for all of our dancers. Let's hear it for our wonderful judges. And for you for supporting Hospice PEI, thank you very much. I'm Paul Allen. Have a great night and a safe drive home, everyone.
Thank you.